everybody. My name is Miss Edwards. I'm a New York City high school teacher, and I'm going to explain to you the supports I provided for multilingual language learners / English language learners, MLL, ELL, in your social studies classes. In this video, I'm going to focus on the 10th grade Passport to Social Studies curriculum, Unit 3, Mini Unit A, Unresolved Global Conflict, 1914 to 1945, World War I and World War II. The lesson that we're looking at is Day 2, Causes of World War I. The focus question for this lesson is, what were the causes of World War I? Our objective for this lesson is to analyze the causes of World War I in Europe and in the Ottoman Empire at multiple scales. In this video, we're going to look at scaffolds provided for the video, how to analyze the causes of World War I with because, but, so. In this lesson, we have an extremely dense text that has advanced vocabulary, a bevy of complex sentences in succession, and no visuals. So this text is in desperate need of scaffolding. My first suggestion is to have students use a glossary or start to compile a personal dictionary so that they can keep track of any important vocabulary in the text. So let's look at the supports provided for this lesson. Okay, so now let's discuss the supports provided for the student-facing video, analyzing causes of World War I with because, but, and so. So support number one, we also use various multimedia to build understanding. So similar to the student-facing video, three ways to identify causes, effects, and the reading, I use visuals to aid students in identifying the causes of World War I before incorporating examples found in the text. So the visuals are helpful for all learners, especially our entering and emerging learners. Support number two, using because, but, and so. I've found that sometimes students struggle with analyzing because they don't know what to do. And I think one skill, one strategy that they could use is using because, but, so. I've found this to be helpful as students start to analyze. One tip is, if students are struggling with using these conjunctions, then maybe they need to use information previously learned material, so something they learned in your class before, like a different topic, or something that's non-content related that they're familiar with, so that they have confidence using because, but, so, without feeling like they don't understand both the skill and the content at the same time. I also find that it's helpful to gamify because, but, so. So you can give them different sentence starters that they could connect. I like to use Kahoot and Nearpod. They have different games in them. Nearpod has a time to climb, which is great. I hope this video helped. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Peace.